What we are going to talk about next is inflorescence, something to do with flowers. As you can see over here, you have an arrangement, a beautiful arrangement. I chose this picture because personally I found it really beautiful. What is beautiful in it is that the arrangement of small flowers on the floral axis. Now, this is our topic that we have to study, inflorescence. What is inflorescence? It is simply the arrangement of flowers on floral axis. As you know, the stem axis gets converted, top of it apical shoot meristem, it gets converted to floral meristem, it becomes floral axis and it is replaced with flowers. Now, how those flowers arrange themselves on that axis is our topic of study over here, and the term that we use for that arrangement is known as inflorescence. What we are going to see is different types of inflorescence. As you can see, this is a simple line diagram just to represent how many types of arrangement of flowers you can observe. You would go out and see that the flowers have multiple arrangements. So, right, they are arranged according to different patterns, and that makes it beautiful. Supposedly, the flower is having small flowers, so it would prefer to become conspicuous and bring all those flowers on a clustered form. So that comes under our study of inflorescence. The various types of inflorescence that we see over here is, I need not to explain it in detail because the pictures are quite descriptive in themselves. All you have to do is remember the names. All right. First one is solitary. If you find a single flower on the floral axis, that would be the example of solitary inflorescence. Then we have the example of raceme. Raceme, otherwise known as racemose. You see one flower, two flower, but they are not present on the same point. All right. One is this, that you are going to find flower one over here, one over here, but this is not the arrangement. As you can observe, the next one comes from next bud, okay, next point from where the meristem is present. So that arrangement is raceme. Then we have spike arrangement. As I told you, this is not on the same point. These two are on the same point, are originating from the same point towards both the sides. Then we have corym. All the flowers are going to raise up to a common level and the flower would look larger in size, as if it is a common flower, but these are different small flowers which have raised up to a uniform level, a similar level, and that gives an appearance of a common flower. Same is the case of umbel, but over here what you can see the difference, that here the originating flowers are reaching up to a level, but all are originating from one point and then reaching up to a common level. That is one point of difference. Then we have capitulum. Then we have panicle and we have cyme inflorescence. You just have to remember the points that they are shown, that are shown in the diagram itself. What are the points that are to be remembered is that there are two types of inflorescence that we have. One is racemose inflorescence. In the picture, as you can see, small buds, newly flowered, newly formed buds are present at the top, while the mature flowers lie at the base. So such an arrangement of flowers on the floral axis is known as racemose inflorescence. The other name for this inflorescence is acropetal. Now, what does acro mean? Acro means tip. This shows that the meristem lies at the tip and whatever is being formed is being added towards downward direction. Okay. Now, acropetal is the youngest flower is located at the tip while the oldest is located at the base. That is acropetal type of inflorescence, or otherwise known as racemose inflorescence. So, the first formed flower would lie over here, then what will happen, that the axis would grow further, then the newly formed flower, this is going to increase in size, then the newly formed, and what you see is that the most recent flower is at the tip, that is acropetal. Contrary to that, or opposite to that, we have another type of inflorescence, that is cymose inflorescence. This is somewhat we have done in the case of capitulum, not capitulum, cyme. What you see over here is that from a common point, all the flowers are rising, whether new or old, they are at same level. This is one type. Otherwise, what you have to remember is that supposedly this is the plant. The younger most lies in the center. The older ones, they are like this. Okay. Are you getting my point? While over here, it was the younger one, younger flower or the most newly formed flower at the tip. Over here, you don't find the most newly formed at the tip. Rather, this is going to have an arrangement which would be somewhat like this. So, this type of inflorescence is basipetal. And the picture is quite descriptive, as you can see from here. While this is racemose, this one is cymose, and you can very well make out the difference that all are rising from the base. Okay, the most younger one lies at the base as compared to the newly formed ones. These could rise further as well. So the younger most is lying at the base instead of being present at the tip, as was in the case of acropetal. So this is all you have to learn in this topic of inflorescence. I would suggest you to practically learn this topic by going out in some field and seeing what are the examples of racemose and cymose. Don't get into the details of different types that we did in the previous slide. This 8 types. Just concentrate on the cymose and racemose, and you will be done with this topic in great depth.